This is number 6 in a series of videos about Thornbury FM, a small radio station in Thornbury, South Gloucestershire, in the southwest of England. Thornbury FM broadcast for 28 days, twice a year, under a short-term restricted service license, SRSL. It started transmitting on 87.7 FM, with simultaneous webcasting, in the autumn of 2005, and its final broadcast under that name was its 9th in autumn 2009. This time, I want to examine the station's attitude towards using presenters who worked for other voluntary radio stations. Thornbury FM endorsed the Community Radio Charter for Europe, the final objective of which promoted communication between community radio stations. Whilst not community radio in the usual sense, hospital radio is another form of radio broadcasting undertaken by volunteers. The nearest hospital radio station to Thornbury FM is 15 miles away in Bristol, Bristol Hospital Broadcasting Service, BHBS, based at the Bristol Royal Infirmary. What kind of exchange did Thornbury FM foster with BHBS? Well, not a healthy one, actually, because Thornbury FM relied heavily on presenters moonlighting from BHBS. Instead of building up a solid base of new presenters based in Thornbury and new to voluntary radio, Thornbury FM took the easy option of relying on volunteers who had experience in radio broadcasting already. I suggest that many of these people contributed for personal reasons, enjoyment, self-publicity, misplaced philanthropy, rather than meeting the constitutional objectives of Thornbury FM and the real needs of the citizens of the Thornbury area. These borrowed presenters showed neither loyalty to their existing station nor to Thornbury FM. They appeared to go with any station, but you were unlikely to see any of them in Thornbury when the station was not transmitting. Most of these hospital radio volunteers regurgitated their same tired BHBS formats whilst on air in Thornbury. Usually they freely admitted their membership of BHBS on their Thornbury FM presenters page. Coming next, we'll take a look at those hospital radio presenters.
Se meten al baño de docentos. Uy, ¿por qué será Ave María, por Dios? Torremolinos, ¿por qué me llevan? Torremolinos, ¿por qué me matan de amor?
Joe Clayton was involved in Thornbury FM from its first broadcast, originally presenting on Saturday mornings for up to 3 hours and playing music from the 1980s onwards and interspersing the tracks with some community information that he had obtained. Although in the spring 2008 broadcast, he just did 2 hours only on Saturday the 17th of May. He was back to two per week in November 2008. As well as BHBS, he was previously at Worcester Hospital Radio, now known as Choice Radio. Choice Radio makes clear its policies on local recruitment and poaching presenters. It's a shame that Joe no longer adheres to that ethos, although a bigger shame that Thornbury FM did not have such a policy. Meanwhile, at BHBS, Joe Clayton had a one-hour program at 8 p.m. on Sundays. It was called Groove, and guess what? It featured music from the 1980s. Ricky Murray was also involved in Thornbury FM from its first broadcast, usually presenting on Sunday evenings and playing 2 hours of soul music and R&B. He was a long-standing member of BHBS, where he had a 90-minute program at 7 p.m. on Tuesdays. Guess what? It was called the Soul and R&B Show. Chris Mountain was involved in Thornbury FM from its second broadcast, I believe, and often presenting on Tuesday afternoons and playing a variety of largely mainstream music. As well as BHBS, he had broadcast on Portishead's SRSL station Point FM. At BHBS, Chris Mountain had a one-hour program at 11 p.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. It was called the Gospel Hour. Gospel, eh? Sue Hazelhurst was involved in Thornbury FM from its second broadcast, usually presenting on Thursdays and Fridays around midday for 2 hours and playing classical music. This long-standing presenter with BHBS was also a studio manager there and previously broadcast at Hospital Radio Crawley. She had also broadcast on other Bristol-based SRSL stations, Commonwealth FM, FEM FM and Cute FM. At BHBS, Sue Hazelhurst had a one-hour programme on Saturdays at 10:15. And guess what? It was called Classics for Pleasure. Ollie Croston was involved in Thornbury FM from its second broadcast, usually presenting on weekdays at 8 p.m. for 2 hours and playing chart and dance music. At BHBS, Ollie Croston was host of the 75-minute Request Line program on Tuesdays at 8:35 p.m. Night nurse,
only you alone can quench the setters. Getting worse.
Ben Park. James Wilson. And Stephen Gardner. Also known as BJS Productions, were involved in Thornbury FM from its fourth broadcast, presenting on Sundays at 10 a.m. for 2 hours and playing pop music interspersed with irreverent humour. On their Thornbury FM presenters page, they withheld the fact that they were involved with BHBS. However, it was revealed on their BJS Productions website. Ben Park has also presented on Curzon FM, an SRSL station in Clevedon. At BHBS, Stephen Gardner, who was made studio manager, had a one-hour programme on Thursdays at 6:30 p.m. called Link with Home, playing patients' easy listening requests. The same evening, Ben Park and James Wilson co-hosted the Thursday edition of the Request Line programme at 8:35 p.m. They no longer do so. Occasionally, Stephen Gardner would forget where he was.
Now on the BHBS.
Don't start doing that.
Now on Thornbury FM. Of course, it's the Link with Home show. Me, Stephen, James, and Ben.
Christmas. I'm sorry, did you just say Link with Home?
Did I?
Yes. Did he?
This is some other random show which we sort of participate in. Well, of course, it's the Music and Waffle show. Great, great show on Thornbury.
But their dual disloyalties could also be the source of more humour.
Yeah, I brought this in. I found this in the archives down at, I think, a place called BHBS.
Really? Those archives.
I don't know.
Never heard of it myself.
No. But I found it in the archives. 9 o'clock, the jazz session. One of my favourite guys. I know him pretty well. He does various other stuff with me, out and about. Chris Mountain with the jazz session.
Oh, cool, yeah.
Then 10 to 12, just to round off the day. A tremendous day on Thornbury FM. It's the Soul of Thornbury with the... Again, a guy who I know quite well.
Yeah,
Ricky Murray.
Yeah,
Ricky Murray, the Soul of Thornbury.
Their pre-recorded humour was given free rein on Thornbury FM, but they were limited by patients' requests at BHBS. but if there are any doubts that they might be loyal, either to Thornbury FM or to BHBS, then those doubts were dispelled by a visit to the BJS Productions homepage. Subsequently, their aspirations seem to have abated somewhat, and they are not touting themselves so much on their website.